IMA scam. What has happened? If our state government would have taken care, this would have not happened. In fact, last year itself, RBI had warned and they had sent a letter also to the Chief Secretary of Karnataka. And you know, lot of rumors were there, you know, this is a fraud company, you know, they are cheating people, you know, the lot of investors are there. Government should have woken up, this problem would have not come. So as the government, when the state is not taking care of the investors and other thing, we Bharatiya Janata Party MPs, we met already Nirmala Sitaramanji, finance minister of the country, and we have explained the whole situation to the madam. Madam also has agreed that because this is not a state, this is a multi-state fraud what has happened, because more investors are in Karnataka and other states also, a lot of people have invested in this IMA company. So being this is a multi-state fraud, central government also has taken interest to save the interests of the investors. Definitely ED has already entered. Definitely we will try all our best to secure whatever the money which is left now. We'll see that it goes to the investors.
Sir, past 12 years he's been running the business, and during his past 12 years, do you think that anybody, any support was there? How did he come up? And you know,
see,
scam, nobody knew about it.
See, this scam which was there. Now since state government negligence, this has happened, first thing. Second thing, now central government has involved and ED has come into the picture. Definitely whoever has done mischief and whoever are involved with this IMA scam, definitely they will all be, all the culprits will be brought into the book and get the justification to the investors.
And do you think that the city is going in the right direction, or do you want a CBI inquiry?
No, because definitely
the
now.
State government gives the permission, the CBI can't.
See, one thing what has happened, see, why I am telling, lakhs of people have invested. Lakhs of people have invested money, and that too all poor people have invested money in this IMA company. What I feel, why state should get scared to hand over this case to CBI? I think before CBI gets in and takes a sumoto action and take this case CBI, I think state should hand over, and state also will have some reputation, because you know all these things have happened because of the state government. I feel the chief minister of the state should hand over this case to CBI, because you know already lot of politicians, local politicians and the ruling party members also are involved. That is what is coming in the paper and all media also showing. Keeping this in mind, you should definitely, and I think state government should hand over this case to CBI.
Sir, what do you think? You know, this Congress and JDS is in the rule for some years, and before that Congress, and before 6 years it was BJP which was in rule, and this company has been running since 13 years.
So I understand the company started 13 years back. Company thrived only 4 or 5 years back. All I think, you know, taking this from your question, what I feel, company with the support of this local government only has thrived all these things. Now definitely I request I demand and request Chief Minister that this case should be handed over to CBI. Let whoever is involved, they will all come into the picture.
Any conspiracy there for him to
see? Definitely without state support, how can he give? State support is controlled by police, everything is officers, bureaucrats, everything is controlled by state. Without state support, how can he leave the country and go? And one more thing, as we all media is showing, lot of politicians who are involved, who are members of JDS and Congress are involved in this.
Okay, so
thank you.
If this doesn't happen, what is the next stand of the BJP?
See, our demand is that this injustification has done to the people, investors. We will definitely get them justification, and we will demand for a CBI handover. This case should be handed over to CBI, and definitely and we will fight for this. Already in the parliament also, we have, when the session is going on, we met the home minister, we have met even the finance minister also. Now we will talk in the parliament also in the zero hour. We'll see that this case would be handed over to CBI. Sir, we'll put pressure on the state government also.
There is a news item that all these investors won't get the money back because it's a Ponzi scheme. And according to Money Laundering Act, all the money will be confiscated and investors will have to pay back the money. So what is your...
Once if this case handed over to CBI, definitely whatever money he has collected, either it will be with him or it will be with one of the his friends or his whatever relatives, anything. Everything will come out. Whatever he has invested anywhere else also, whether it is in our country or elsewhere in the world, wherever he has invested, that all would be brought here and given to the investors.
So you are
thank
sure
you.
That, investors won't be deceived, they'll get the money.
See, definitely whatever money is there, definitely I will see that, you know, as a parliamentary member of the Bangalore city, with central government support, I'll see that it will reach the investors.